What's up, guys? Welcome to the channel, Rocking the Country. I'm Don. Hope things are going well for you. I'm doing a song today that I don't even know how this is going to work, how well, but it's going to go in the Country Heart series. I know some of the lyrics, they resonate, and I'm like, it's got a lot of heart, so we're going to find out. And I want to give a shout out to my friend Heather. Heather, she gave me this hat, Hamilton Farms. Heather's a pretty cool chick. So anyway, we went to kindergarten together. So here, and then right on through high school, then right on through college, and we're still in touch with one another. So let's see the Stones, Angie. Boop. Just as I remember. Elements of country in here. You know, I'm listening to this in headphones, and it is such a dramatic difference. I've said this in so many songs, but good God. But the heart in this song, too, I mean, I don't know who wrote this. I mean, this is something that happened, you know. Could have happened to a lot of people. I don't know if Angie's an actual person or just a name used for the song, you know. But, man, so much going on. I've heard that line so many times and never really thought about it in the context of this song. One, if you're the person, Angie, to whom the song is written, and you hear it, you'd be bawling your eyes out, I imagine. But that one line in there that says, "Ain't it good to be alive?" I don't know what that's about. That changes the whole context of everything else in here. They were broke. They didn't, I think the line is, they didn't, with no loving in our souls and no money in our coats, I think. Being broke is nothing new. Lots of relationships go through broke spells. But no loving in our souls. But he clearly loves her. Everywhere he looks, he sees her eyes. So, I don't know. Do some of you guys know the backstory? I bet some of you do. Warren Burlingham, you know so much stuff about music. Cowtail Customs, David Emsweiler, you know tons of stuff. I don't know if you're a fan of the Stones, David, but I remember I saw an interview probably 10 years ago. And I don't know if it was, I don't remember if it was Alan Jackson or Vince Gill, but something tells me it was Alan Jackson. And he was talking about the Stones. And I just remember that he had said that, like, a lot of people don't realize it, but that the Stones were country before most of us were country. And it was something to that effect. And I was like, what? Whoa. Like, I never heard the Stones as country. But every so often I'll hear an element in how they present themselves. And in a song like this, you've got, in this, they call them violins. You've got the strings, But the delivery, the lyrics, the feel, the time that Mick took to sing the lyrics, the spacing in between, the heart behind it, just hits me the way a country song does. Beautiful ballads usually do anyway, but I'm not going to rate that. That's just for my country heart playlist, which those of you who are new, it's in there. The song's not marketed as country, but there's a country heart to them. Another shout out to Heather, and I'll be seeing you one of these days. I'm sure of it. And that's it, guys. Have a great day. See you in another video. I'll keep rocking the country.